The private sector is a strong player in the creation of employment opportunities for young people. And like most of our national policies indicate, we are looking at private sector-led growth.
If we're making policies, it should be involving all the policymakers, including all of the private sector.
Now, if we're looking at private sector-led growth, then the focus should be on creating a conducive business environment for the private sector to be able to thrive.
We have solutions that are really inclusive of everyone to understand that this is a strategy and this is a goal that we'll be following.
So first and foremost, the role of the private sector is to create the opportunities that the young people need so that the economy can grow.
When we talk about one of the bigger challenges at in Uganda today, it's this question of unemployment. It's certainly one of the top challenges in the country.
Unemployment is affecting the country in various ways. We have the skilled, the ants, the semi-skilled, and those that totally don't have any skills at all. And in terms of employment, is that we have a mismatch between those who are being skilled, a disconnect between the employers and the employees.
The word unemployment gets a lot of headline press in Uganda. It's a big issue on everyone's minds, but it's probably not the biggest story in the labor market here. So it's true that unemployment levels are high and rising, especially in a few specific parts of the country, including Kampala, where UBOS puts figures at above 20%. So that's definitely a big concern.
Unemployment, as we are all aware, is more acute, especially among the youth. A lot of the infrastructure that we require to be in the new age are not yet in place. Accessibility, for instance, to internet and the cost of internet, the cost of new technology simply is way unaffordable for most companies.
For us to have inclusive growth, we need to appreciate that in the world today, education is not something which happens when you're in school. It is a continuous process.
Okusoma kwa finga Uganda, education system unaiya kwa value. Ntirabi wakusomesa, biyebiyari wo, atingi nse gende chuka. Bakusomesa ebiyaita, chukanga ebidi present, ate ebidi different, kusinzira kubi wasoma.
Everyone at any given point is making sure that they are adding to their skills, irrespective of the sector in which they are. And I think we need to be able to do more of that so that we are not left behind.
I think there will be three key drivers of inclusive growth in Uganda, and they're very broad drivers. The first one is raising the productivity of the country's smallholder farmers, who currently make up the bulk of its workforce. The second big driver, I think, will be diversifying the country's exports of high-value products and services. Both of those points are going to require a lot of money, a lot of government investment.
The future is much brighter than the past, so we should be looking to the future with a lot of optimism. There are a lot of new jobs being created. We are talking a lot about the jobs that are being lost. We are not talking much about the jobs being created. Social media experts, a few years ago, nobody was doing that job.
It's clear that the workforce of the future will need to be able to adapt even more quickly to changing circumstances than it is already today.
A lot of new innovation, the Uber drivers, for instance, we were not talking about those jobs just a few years ago, online shopping markets and all these things. So a lot of new opportunities and new jobs are being created because of what we are seeing happening now with artificial intelligence.
I believe that in order to get the workforce ready for that, there needs to be a deep overhaul of the education system. And that overhaul needs to happen, so it needs to go from teaching people how to remember facts to teaching people how to learn.
Singa government edeka kama koyo. Then abantu mu Uganda katube yongero bunji. Barabade bagenda makoyo ngono basabe mirimo, nabawe bimirimo nabakora nabofana yokora.
I think one of the first things which clearly needs to happen is to ensure that our small and medium enterprises are growing faster, and are creating durable jobs.
I think that there needs to be an encouragement or empowerment on women to encourage them to come and take over the responsibility and take these jobs as their occupation.